you're not going to lose 10 pounds. If you want to love well, you have to love well with the fuel of the gospel. So you have to think about it. Got to think on the gospel. So as our musicians come up, I'm going to sing a hymn of invitation. I wanted to encourage you guys that if any of this is kind of pulling some strings in your heart, or if you feel you have a wrong with someone, or a tension with someone, or a disagreement, and you're not loving well, man, life is short. Don't waste time. You do not have enough time to get caught up in grudges. You don't have enough time to not love each other well. And the world around you doesn't have enough time to watch a church disagree with each other. It doesn't. I wish I had a spray bottle, because I was going to show you guys what your life looked like, and I was going to spray the mist, and then I was going to try and like save everybody in the room, and by the time I got halfway there, the mist would be on the ground. You do not have time to love each other well. I'm going to love my wife really well today. I'm going to love everyone I run into really well today. And maybe awkward, but it's got to be natural. Jesus Christ only. That's the only place it comes from. To the praise and glory of God, so that the world may see a church that loves well. And please accept our offerings now, God. Thanks for lending it to us in the first place. In Jesus' name, amen. Interest meeting right after this. It's going to be on the second classroom on the right. You can go down and Alyssa will be heading that up. So if you're interested in VBS, volunteering, come on out. Let's talk a bit and get you up to speed with what's going on there. And other than that, let's just pray. And I think there's something I'm missing. Just ask me again later this week. So I'll pray. You guys can sit while I pray. God, thank you for this church. Thank you for the church of Philippi and that you have Paul write a letter to them that we can kind of get a sneak peek behind the curtain of that time period. And I thank you for the gospel. I thank you that Jesus, you died for us and that your blood covered all our sin. You took what we deserved. And then the third day, you still wanted to see us. So you rose from the dead. And because of your resurrection, Lord, and your death, we now have life eternal in you. And there's no other way. That is the only way. It's easy. God, I pray that it would become just that easy to read our Bibles and pray too. We love you. We need you for everything. And I pray that a spirit of love would just kind of cascade over this room right now as we all say goodbye and hug and shake hands and go out to eat. In Jesus' name, amen.